Hey guys, Vikas over here and you are watching We Are Genius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around Raspberry Pi and Arduino. We will see how to access IOs of Arduino Uno by using Fermata protocol, and that is from Raspberry Pi. Fermata is a protocol that is used to communicate with microcontrollers from any tablet or PC over the serial interface, and this helps in interacting with the GPIOs of the microcontroller from the host PC. And for that, you can take advantage of any programming language like Java, C, C++, and the libraries for those are readily available. There are implementations of Fermata for other platforms also, along with Arduino. You can find support for Fermata if you are using any Arduino IDE that is released after 2008. You must be thinking, why should I use Fermata, as you can program the Arduino by using Raspberry Pi as well. But if you are using Fermata, that lets you access the GPIOs of Arduino from any host device natively without uploading the sketch each time you change the sketch. This opens up a lot of opportunities with Raspberry Pi. Like, you can use Arduino as EDC for your Raspberry Pi, as it doesn't have native EDC pins. You can also interface a whole lot of sensors by the additional GPIOs that you will be getting after you connect your Arduino with Raspberry Pi by using the Fermata protocol. And it eliminates the usage of ICs like port expanders or external ADCs that we generally use with Raspberry Pi. And in this video, we'll see a basic example of blinking the onboard LED of Arduino that is connected to pin number 13 from Raspberry Pi. And for this, we'll be using Java to interact with the Arduino. And we'll be using the Fermata 4J library for Java, that is for Fermata protocol. So being said that, let's get started, guys. So guys, to start with this, we'll connect the Arduino to PC first, and we'll upload the standard Fermata sketch to the Arduino, which will enable us to access the Arduino from any PC, and in our case, the Raspberry Pi. And after that, we'll use a simple test program from our PC so that you know that the Fermata is working properly before getting into the Raspberry Pi. And we'll try to access the pin number 13 or the LED that is available on the Arduino itself. So let's first connect the Arduino to the PC. After that, just open up Arduino IDE, and if you are using any version after 2008, it comes with Fermata prepackaged. And to use that, get into examples, then get into Fermata, and over here you will get different sketch options, like if you are interested in accessing all the inputs, or if you are like looking for analog, echo string, old standard Fermata, that is prior to version 2.2, or servo, anything. But over here I'm just going to use the standard Fermata, which lets us access all the pins as input as well as output. So I'll just select the COM port that your Arduino is connected to, and let's upload the sketch. Now in the meantime, when the code is getting uploaded, let's download one test application that is from Fermata.org website, which will let us to access the Arduino using the Fermata protocol from our PC. And over here on Fermata.org page, that is wiki page, you get like different test applications for different OS and versions, like for Linux, like 32-bit, 64-bit, for Mac OS X, for Windows, you get different applications respectively. So over here, I've just as I'm using Windows, I'll just download this one, and as I have already downloaded, I'll just open it up and just let's run it, and let's see if we are able to access the Arduino, which is uploaded with the standard Fermata sketch using the Fermata protocol. So over here, just select the port that your Arduino is connected to, and you can see over here it is just presenting us the different pins of our Arduino board. And as the serial port is by default used by the Fermata protocol, we are not able to access the pin number 0 and 1. Now you can see the analog values are getting changed because I don't have any input to any analog pin. And over here I have not connected any peripherals, so I'll just check out if the standard output pin, that is the pin 13, which is the onboard connected LED, is working or not. So I'll make it output and let's make it. Now let's make it low. Now you can pretty much access all the pins also, as well as you can use the analog pins. And over here on the drop down, you will get different options, like if you want to use the particular pin as input or output, and it will tell you the status if you are using it as input. Now you will also get servo option, and as well as you will get PWM options for PWM enabled pin. So you can see it's pretty much working. So let's connect our Arduino to Raspberry Pi, and we'll try to access the Arduino from our Raspberry Pi by using the formatter protocol. And for that, we'll be using Java application on our Raspberry Pi. So guys, before starting the development of our Java application for Raspberry Pi, which will interact with the Arduino module by using formatter, we first need to connect the Arduino board to our Raspberry Pi. And that is by using the USB port of Raspberry Pi. You just need to simply plug in your Arduino board to the Pi. So over here, you can note that we are not using the serial port header that is present on GPIO headers of Raspberry Pi. Instead, we are using the USB connection between Arduino and Raspberry Pi. Now after connecting the Arduino to Raspberry Pi, let's open up one SSH connection with the Raspberry Pi. And over here, just type in LSUSB. And this should list all the devices those are connected by using the USB interface to the Raspberry Pi. And over here in my case, it is showing me a new device which is like ID of 2A030043. But if you are not sure which device is your like Arduino board and all, you can simply unplug the device, type in the command LSUSB, and again plug the device, and you should again type in the command LSUSB. And just check in the new device ID that is appearing over here. Now to check which serial port is assigned for the particular USB to UART bridge of our Arduino, we can simply type in the command sudo /dev /tty*. And for me, I have the new device appearing over here, that is TTY-ACM0. Now again, if you are not sure which serial port is for the Arduino you have plugged in, you can simply unplug and run type in this command. And again, after plugging in, you can type in the command and you can check the difference, or you can see which port is appearing over here. But in my case, this is dev/tty-acm0. Now make a note of this port name, which will be used in our application. Now coming to the Java application, I'm going to use Eclipse over here. But you can use any IDE that you are familiar with. And we will be creating our Java application over here on the PC, and we will transfer the created executable jar file to our Raspberry Pi, which will be running there. Now coming to the application, I have over here created a simple project that is Formata. And again, if you are new to like Java application development and running Java application on Raspberry Pi, you can check my earlier tutorial on this, for which actually I have given the links down below in the description. Now for this project, actually I have used one library to interact with the Arduino using the Formata protocol, that is Formata 4J, and you can get the repository link down below in the description. But if you want to use this, you need to create your own binary file, or you need to compile it yourself. But actually I downloaded one pre-compiled binary file from ambienrepository.com. And actually I have put all the links down below for the library file as well as some dependency file, which you can see over here. I have downloaded Formata 4J library, that is from ambienrepository.com, and along with we need couple of dependencies that is one for simple serial connector, that is JSSC, and one more for logging, that is SLF4J. Actually, I have provided all these links down below in the description. Now, after you download all the required dependencies, you simply need to add those to the build path. And in Eclipse, that is pretty much easy. Get into build path, click on configure build path, and click on external, like add external jar files, and select the jar files just you downloaded. Now you can see over here, I have already added the three files, that is Formata4j, JSSC, and SLF4j. Now over here you can see I have created a simple class file, that is first, what it is doing is it is taking an object of the serial port, that in our case TTY ACM0, that is corresponding the, it is corresponding to the Arduino port. This might change for you if your Arduino is detected on different port. Then after that we need to use device.start. Then after that which basically initiate communication between the devices. Now device.ensure initialization is on, that is waiting initialization to be done. Then after that I have just created one simple object for pin, and in my case that is pin number 13, that is the default LED present on the Arduino board. But you can over here change these pin numbers if you are using any other external hardware. Now I have just set the mode of the pin, that pin dot set mode, and I have made it output. After that I have just created a simple while loop that toggles the state of the output pin, that is pin. Pin dot set value will do the job. You can set either 1 or 0. Now if you are wondering if you can do only digital inputs and outputs, but actually you can do many things like I2C, serial, SPI and all other protocols also from your Raspberry Pi. But in this video I'm not going to cover all those things, but for your reference I'll just drop the links down below in the description if you want to explore it yourself. Now I'll just run this project once so that we'll be able to create the executable jar file for this. So nothing to worry about, it is throwing error. This is what happens if you run like compile Linux application on Windows. So no worry about it. Now I just click on this, right click, then click on export, select like runnable jar file under Java. Again, all this I have covered in my previous tutorials on Java application development for Raspberry Pi. You can check those out. Yes, yes. Now to transfer the created executable jar file to Raspberry Pi, I have used one application, that is WinSCP, but you can use any FTP or SFTP clients. I'll just upload this couple of files. So click on upload, and over here on terminal, get into desktop, and you will see the test.jar and test_lib file. This is the executable jar file, and this test_lib folder contains all the dependencies, which again you can check the Formata4j, JSSC, and SLF4j jar files. Now let's try to run this particular application, and we should see the LED of the Arduino board starts blinking. To do that, I'll just use the command sudo java. So these are some warnings. Actually, I have not configured the logging, and you can see the LED 13 of the Arduino board is blinking, so it's kind of working. Now getting into the code once more, you can see over here I have commented device.stop, which actually should be called before closing this application, but as I have used while loop I have not used this. But in your application you certainly you can use this to avoid errors and all. So that's pretty much about it guys, this all for today. I hope you have enjoyed this video. If so, hit the like button, and if you have not subscribed to my channel yet, you can definitely do it by hitting the subscribe button. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.